Hello everyone! In this video, I'll talk about functional and non-functional requirements. Firstly, let's see what are those requirements. Functional requirements are the statements say what system services should be provided instead of showing how it should be done. These requirements may also state what system shouldn't do. In functional requirements, system services must be described very detailed, and statements should be complete and consistent as much as possible. Meanwhile, non-functional requirements define various system properties like reliability, response time, or storage requirements, and constraints such as input-output device, capability, system representations, and others. Process requirements may also be specified as non-functional requirements, mandating a particular IDE, programming language, or development method. And don't forget that non-functional requirements usually are more important than functional ones, because if these are not met, the system might be useless. For example, if we have a computer game that has many functionalities, but it only displays one frame per second, we will not be able to play this game. As you may understand, there are many different non-functional requirements. In this slide, you can see what main types are and how they are connected. There are three large groups: product, organizational, and external requirements. Product requirements specify how delivered product must behave, including execution speed, reliability, and others. Organizational requirements are based on organizational policies and procedures. For example, process standards, implementation requirements, and so on. External requirements are about external factors that may affect the system and its development process. For example, legislative requirements, ethic requirements, and others. Non-functional requirements may affect the overall architecture of system rather than the individual components. For example, to ensure that performance requirements are met, you may have to organize the system to minimize interactions between components. A single non-functional requirement, such as security requirement, may generate a number of related functional requirements that define system services and are required. Some conflicts between new requirements and already existing ones should also be considered. In this table, you can see the most common metrics of non-functional analysis. This is speed, size, reliability, and portability. As you can see, the speed can be measured by process transactions per second or user per event response, and even by screen refresh time. Size is usually measured by megabytes. Easy-to-use measure is based on training time or number of help frames. Reliability could be measured by mean time of failure or availability. Key points of this lecture. Functional requirements are statements of services that the system should provide. Non-functional requirements are constraints on services or functions offered by the system. Non-functional requirements may be more important and affect the system architecture. It also should be measurable, and appropriate metrics should be used. Thank you for your attention.